walking cheetah with a hat full of napalm. I'm the runaway son of a nuclear inbound. I am the world's forgotten boy, the one who searches in. Mötley Crüe is the rock band who's going to destroy the new wave. Did they manage to do it? There's no doubt Mötley changed music history. The band carries a story of his own, and during 1986, Nikki Sixx, the songwriter and bass player of the band, downed his thoughts on plenty of journals, pieces of paper, or anything he could write on. Eventually, he forgot he ever wrote them down. Back in 87, there weren't any drug Nikki, or Sicky, as he self-titled himself, wouldn't do. Even less heroin. His life was a disaster, some would say. Did he care? No, why would he? When the heroin kicks in, he was in heaven. At least for a while. Back in 87, I was in Mötley Crüe, and we were touring the world, we were selling out stadiums, and we had our own yet. The life was from the outside absolutely perfect, but I knew I wasn't a drug addict. I was still locked into the machine. I was sort of communicating to my diary what it was like to be an heroin addict, and to be supposedly at the top of my dream. I really felt the story needed to come out, and it's been many years. Last time I did heroin was in 1987, so it's been over 20 years. December 25th, 1986, Van Nuys.
Merry Christmas. Well, that's what people say at Christmas, right? Except normally they have someone to say it to. They have their friends and family all around them. They haven't crouched naked under a Christmas tree with a needle in their arm like an insane person in a mansion in Van Nuys. They're not out of their minds and writing in a diary. And they're not watching their holiday spirit coagulating in a spoon. I didn't speak to a single person today. I thought of calling Bob Timmons, but why should I ruin his Christmas? I guess I've decided to start another diary this time for a few different reasons. 1. I have no friends left. 2. So I can read back and remember what I did the day before. 3. So if I die, at least I have a paper trail of my life. Nice little suicide note. Merry Christmas. It's just you and me, diary. Welcome to my life.
And here's Bob Timmons.
By Christmas 1986, Nikki had been addicted to heroin and cocaine for at least a year, well, possibly longer. As a drug counselor, I first met Nikki when Mötley Crüe's manager Doug McKee called me in to work with the band singer Vince Neil. Nikki was initially hostile to me. He tried to get me barred from going backstage or being around them. Nikki and I slowly formed a relationship, and early in 1986, he asked me for help with his own addictions. I advised him to go into rehab center, but he refused and said he didn't need to. He was very stubborn on that issue. Over the years, I worked with plenty of platinum-selling artists, from the Rolling Stones to Red Hot Chili Peppers and all the points in between. And let me make one thing clear from the start. Mötley Crüe, more than anybody, wrote the book for corruption and partying. In that area, they were the most extreme people I ever met. And Nikki, oh yeah, he was the most extreme of them all. For many years, Nikki had one motto.
I'm going to do exactly what I want to do and fuck everybody else. Nobody would believe the shit that happens inside my head. It's haunted. Now I've come down from the drugs, it seems like a sick play that I saw in a theater somewhere. 30 minutes ago, I could have killed somebody. Or better yet, myself.